Alright, going through some stuff today that was given to me. I'll preface this video right now by saying I really don't have any plans on keeping this. If you think that you might want to buy it or whatever, contact me through the messenger. I don't see myself keeping this just because, you know, this actually, as you'll see in the video, this would make a good parts set for somebody who had one in a little better shape. This is a Westinghouse jet set. Let's see there. Jet set Westinghouse mini combo. And I'll try to find a year and put it into video links, but it's basically a small black and white TV, 12 inch. It has an alarm clock on it, and the clock does work. And under the lid here, we have a 4-speed mini changer and an AM/FM radio. Now, as we can see, there is some trim. Sure, there was a trim panel on the front of here that's gone. I'm sure there was some kind of trim panel over that speaker that's gone. And I'm sure that there was something over this side of the TV that's also gone. Other than that, it's in alright shape. The cover's still good. The 45 adapter's still present. Let's turn this thing on and give it a go over. And I'll show you what it's doing. So first we'll start, this is a selector switch down here. So first we'll start on radio. And you can turn this on either with the sleep timer, or you can use the master on switch. So here's the volume control for the radio. And right now it's on AM. Now, the tuner is stuck. The dial string isn't broken, but it needs to be freed up. I have not opened this thing up yet. But there's AM. Here's FM. So the AM and the FM does work. Let's see. Phonograph. The phonograph, I don't know who made it. It has a semaphore. I hear the motor humming. The table's free, but it's not spinning. I don't hear any output from the cartridge. Alright, so now let's try the television. Let's see. Turn it on TV. And I'll cut the light for a moment. And we get a picture. Now, the only signal source I have available to me at the moment, and don't laugh, but I found my old Syncor Color Cadet, and of course I don't have C batteries to put in it, so it's 12 volts, so I'm powering it off of this slightly discharged lawnmower battery, and it does the job. It's getting us a signal over here, so let's see. This should be the crosshatch pattern. Oh, there it is. Tuner's real dirty. So we can see the challenges it has. It probably needs caps. I hate to just blame everything on caps, but that's what this looks like. Let's see, get the color dots. So everything's compacted at the bottom. There's vertical, horizontal, color bars. So, alright. I'm gonna yank the turntable out. Let's see what's jamming up the wheel there. Alrighty. So we got the turntable spinning. The motor was just a little stuck. It needs to be taken apart and re-lubed and everything, but I don't think we got any output out of it. Let me see. Let's see. Let's hit reject. Yes, and I can watch it changing the color of the grooves on the record. Okay, the 78 needle's still good. Oopsie, I just cut the power. Now it's gonna... Alright, so we see that probably got a dead cart, the needle. You can see the first grooves of the record there. And this record's pretty clean, but this is something that I've been moving around for 20-something years, never listened to, and whatever. Let's see what kind of cart's in here. Oh, just a Tetrad's cart that snaps in the top. Shouldn't be too hard to find another one of those. This might be something else disconnected under there, who knows. Alright, so both the aerials are on the back. And, got antenna connections for VHF, UHF, and FM. The time set for the clock is here. Cord, horizontal and vertical hold sticking through the back. And it's a model BC8. BC8-2A8. Westinghouse Electric Corporation. BC128870. Well, I guess the bend of the tag is gone. There's the full model number. BC12A870 walnut. And I have to, I believe this is tube. Let me open it up and see. Alright, so in back here, yes, it is a tube set. You see it's got a Compactron there and circuit board. There's another Compactron back there. Pretty dusty inside. I guess we got a tube chart over here I can't make out. The speaker is made in Japan and it looks like it has a date code on it possibly. I see 7071. Or maybe that's not 7071. I don't know. Hard to see any codes on anything else in here. But this is what it looks like inside. So, of course, up top, there's the record changer. And there's the clock up there. You can see the set shaft. Longest set shaft ever put on a clock, I'll bet. And I'm guessing wrapped up there, that's probably a rectifier tube or something. And then here's the radio. Well, no, there's the TV chassis for sure. And then we got a piece of cardboard up here. And above that is the radio portion. But But yeah, as you see, it works. It's got the aerials. There's a lot of good parts on this thing. If you have one of these, it's in better cosmetic shape, but maybe has some major flaws or missing electronics or burned out transformers or something. This would be an excellent set. This would be an excellent part set. And really, the cabinet's in... I see something was screwed through there one time. But, I mean, the cabinet's in good shape. I mean, this is plastic up here. This dust cover isn't even that bad. It's not cracked. I'm sure you'd have to get this... Might have had it taped before. You'd have to get that off. But I'm sure that would polish out. You can see there was a sunscreen on here at one time. But, you know, the clock works. Everything basically works. It's just it's missing these trim pieces. And the one on the front of the radio here. The turntable would clean up nicely, I'm pretty sure. That mat needs to be glued back down, but the mat is supple. The idler wheel on this turntable is fine. It's still soft, believe it or not. The idler wheel is good. So, yep, if you're interested in it, shoot me a message here on YouTube. Make me an offer. Of course, you know, it would be better. I'm about an hour outside of New Orleans. You know, pickup is always best. But, you know, shipping is possible. But, I mean, it's going to cost a little bit, you know, for my time and packing materials and to really get this thing packed right, you know. It's not terribly heavy, really. I guess about 10, 15 pounds. So it is shippable. But, yep. So there's the Westinghouse Jet Set Mini Combo from around 1970 or so. See y'all later.